vegan cheese. What a topic. I mean, we could talk for days about vegan cheese. Aren't you sick of hearing that vegan cheese tastes rubbish? I know I certainly am. Because you know what? There's good and there's bad vegan cheeses. Some people have a favorite brand. So for today's video, we're gonna delve right in to the murky, complicated world of vegan cheddar cheese and go through 9 of the most widely available vegan cheddar cheeses and rank them from best to worst. So watch on if you want to find what is the best vegan cheddar cheese. But it's not just the best vegan cheddar cheese that we will be finding today. We're gonna tell you which one tastes the best, which one melts the best, which one goes best in a vegan cheese toasty, and we're gonna give you the recipe for that vegan cheese toasty. Let us know your thoughts down in the comments below. What's your favorite vegan cheese? Which vegan cheese type should we test next? And let's get into the video. First up, let's meet our cheesy contenders. All 9 of them. Cheese number 1, from Bute Island, we have the cheese mild cheddar style. Number 2, also from Bute Island, we have cheese mature cheddar style. Cheese number 3 is Vialife's cheddar block. Cheese number 4 is Vialife's epic mature. Cheese number 5 is from Green V and it's their cheddar flavor block. Cheese number 6 is Coco's deliciously mellow cheese. Cheese number 7 is Applewood with their deliciously smoky cheese. Cheese number 8 is the Mexicana spicy cheese. And cheese number 9 is Follow Your Heart's cheddar shreds. They're the contenders. It's an absolutely star-studded list of cheeses that are going to be fighting for the title today. Now there's a few rules we need to get through before we start. First off, this is all opinion. We haven't been paid to do this. We bought all these cheeses ourselves. We're going for brand names here. Brands that you can get in your local supermarket and maybe even internationally available as well. Today, we're gonna go through 3 testing stages. The first test is a straight up taste test. The second test that we'll be doing is a melt test. I'm gonna be putting all of these into the oven and we'll see how they melt. And number 3, third and final, we're gonna make a cheese toasty out of the top 5. From the previous 2 tests, and we're gonna get Ian down and we're gonna taste the cheese toasties and we're gonna rank them blind from best to worst. I think that sounds like a pretty fair test.
Yeah man, that's a good test. Like you're doing the 1, the 2, the 3. Always opinion, it's hard to get away from opinion.
Yeah, but it's okay because we've all got opinions and it's okay to have an opinion.
Oh, I don't know about that, you know.
Well, let's just get on with it. First up is the cheese mild cheddar style. Let's have a taste.
Okay.
So that has a lovely crumbly texture. It tastes really, really quite cheesy. This is surprisingly good for vegan cheese, I would say. That's gonna get a whopping 5 points out of 5. Next up from the same company is Cheese's mature cheddar style. Now surprisingly, given that's called Cheese Mature, I don't think it's more mature than the mild. It's got a little bit of a rubbery mouthfeel. It feels a little bit artificial when you bite into it. Cheese Mature Cheddar Style, 2 points out of 5. Next up is Vialife's Cheddar Block. And just by looking at it, it's a little bit more rubbery, shall we say. Let's see how this one tastes. One of the things that makes vegan cheese a bit weird is coconut oil. It's often used because it melts and it helps the cheese to melt. But I feel like there's a little bit of a coconutty flavor here in this Vialife cheddar block. As you can tell, I'm not loving this one. Vialife cheddar block, 2 points out of 5. On to cheese number 4. This is Vialife's epic mature. Now I have to say, I love that name. This should be good. It still has an odd appearance. You can see it's kind of rounded in the shape of the pack, but I have high hopes for this cheese.
Okay.
This is a good vegan cheese. Vialife's Epic Mature. It's got a real mature cheddar-y sharpness. Now, if you used to be into cheddar cheese, you know what you're looking for with the word mature. And that Vialife is really delivering that. I'm very impressed by Vialife's Epic Mature. That's gonna get 4 points out of 5. Next up is Green V's Cheddar Flavor Block. It looks pretty good. Let's see how it tastes. Okay, Green V, I see what you're doing there. You know what, with this Green V cheese, the texture is It's okay, it's quite crumbly. It actually has the color of a carrot, and I believe they use natural ingredients in here, which might be why it doesn't taste quite as cheesy, but it tastes quite natural. I don't dislike it, it's kind of in the middle, so I'm gonna give it 3 points out of five. Now time for Coco's deliciously mellow cheese. It's definitely yellow, but is it mellow? Let's find out. Coconut, Okay, with cocoa, I'm gonna start with the good. The crumble is amazing. However, it is blinded by the taste, the kind of weird taste of coconut. In my opinion, coconut and cheese do not go together. Because that doesn't work for me, I'm gonna have to give this one 2 points out of five. Now, a big one, I've been waiting for this. This is Applewood's Deliciously Smoky. A lot of people have been talking about Applewood. This is a big favorite for people on social media. Let's see what I think. This is super smoky. There is a smokiness running throughout. I wonder if they used liquid smoke maybe. Also, it looks really cool. Check this out. That is a layer of what I assume is paprika, which gives it a really nice spicy edge. Sharp and pleasing Applewood, 4 points out of five. Next, Mexicana's spicy cheese. Let's have a go at this. Bit of water needed after that. They're not kidding when they say spicy. So that one is made with red and green peppers, which is really cool. But overall, the taste of the cheese is, it's almost incomparable to the rest because you are tasting something that is Mexican spiced. It's really spicy, but I like it. I'm a fan of that. I can see how it would work well on pizza. You could put that in a burrito and you'd be in a really good place. Mexicana spicy cheese, that's a massive win. 4 points out of five. Which brings us to the last one of our contenders, the Follow Your Heart Cheddar Shreds. Let's see how they taste. Wow. So I'm not a fan of this Follow Your Heart, as you could probably tell. It's got a really upsetting aftertaste. It tastes quite chemically. There's a powdery texture. This is the kind of thing that gives vegan cheese a bad name. Follow Your Heart Cheddar Shreds, not winning it for me. 1 point out of five. Now that's the taste test done. We've got all of our scores in front of us, so let's rearrange them and see how everybody has done. In first place is Cheese's Mild Cheddar. Joint second place goes to three different cheeses. There is Applewood's, Vialife's Epic Mature, and that spicy Mexicana, all in second place. In tied third place, we have Green V's Cheddar Flavor, and the mature cheddar slices from Cheese. And then tying for fourth place, there's a lot of ties going on, we have Coco's Deliciously Mellow and that Vialife cheddar block, which was kind of rubbery. And in last place, absolute no question here, is Follow Your Heart's Cheddar Shreds. Now onto the melt test. Now I can't be bothered to grate all of these by hand, but really they need to be grated for the melt test. So I'm gonna use a blender with the little grater setting. That's gonna make it super quick and easy. There we go, the cheeses are grated and I've measured out exactly the same amount into each hole of this muffin tin. So I used that. It's basically one ice cream scoop of grated cheese. And I'm gonna put that in the oven to see how it melts at 180 degrees. The cheeses are out of the oven. We have some that have melted and some that haven't, which is exactly what we would have wanted to see in a test like this. Number one, Cheese Mild Cheddar Style. It's fully melted, it's creamy, touch of separation, but not too bad. That would do a good cheese pull, 5 points out of 10. Next, the Cheese Mature Cheddar Style. This one's a bit more tacky, as you can see. This one is still melted a bit, so it's gonna get good points, but that tackiness is gonna lose it some points. It wouldn't really cheese pull. 4 points out of 10. Next up, the Vialife Cheddar. This is looking a little bit alien-like. It's got a kind of plasticky feel. It's softened, but not melted. This is not really what you're looking for, but it has softened, so I'm gonna give this one 3 points out of 10. The newer Vialife product, which is their Epic Mature, has done a much better job of melting. There's a touch of oil separation, which I'm not too happy about, but I could absolutely cheese pull this bad boy. Vialife Epic Mature, 3 points out of 10. Oh, Green V Cheddar, you've not really done it, have you? This is sad to see. So it's softened, but we still have shreds. It's tacky. That is definitely not what we're looking for in a melty cheese. So this is gonna get 2 points out of 10. Cocoa, deliciously mellow cheese. I mean, look, we've still got actual shreds. Not much has happened at all in that oven. This is not a melt, it's barely softened. 1 point out of 10.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Applewood, deliciously smoky, definitely one of my favorite flavors, and this is a good melt. There's a touch of oiliness, but this would give an absolutely epic cheese pull. This is gonna get 5 points out of 10. Mexicana spicy cheese. So this one has melted well. It's got a weird color though. The marks are gonna be hurt a little bit by this brown color. I'm gonna give this 4 points out of 10. And finally, the follow your heart cheddar shreds, which really didn't smash it in the taste test, have definitely melted. But what you see here is they do have a weird consistency. It's melted and softened, but it's also like clumped together. This is not really what you want. It's not gonna cheese pull, it's more gonna cheese splodge. 3 points out of 10. So let's have another look at the scoreboard and rearrange them in order of which is the most melty. The top spot for the meltiest cheese goes to Cheese's mild cheddar, and it's tied with the Applewood smoked vegan cheese, which also melted amazingly. Cheese's vegan mature cheese came in second place with 4 points, alongside Mexicana's spicy cheese, also with 4 points. And then in third place, we had Epic Mature from Violife, along with the cheddar block from Violife and the follow your heart shreds, which were kind of there or thereabouts in the melty steaks. In second to last place was Green V's cheddar flavor. And in last place, with very little melt at all, is Coco's deliciously mellow. Now I'm gonna add these scores up and see just who won across the batch. So totting up those scores to get an all round winner. Who is gonna win? Let's find out. Well, we've only got 110 on the board. There's a 9, there's an 8, 2 7s, a 5, a 5, a 4, and a 3. The results are in, totted up, left to right, top to bottom. We have a clear winner, which is the Cheese Vegan Mild, which is a surprise to me. I would have thought their Vegan Mature would have been better, but their Vegan Mild, 10 out of 10. Followed closely behind by the Applewood, which a lot of people love, that Applewood cheese. That's got 9 points out of 10 in second place. In third place is Mexicana's super spicy cheese. It did good on the flavor, it did good on the melt. And then following on from that, we have Cheese's Mature Cheddar, Epic Mature from Violife, the Cheddar Block from Violife, the Green V, Follow Your Heart in second to last place, and Coco's Deliciously Mellow in last place. So we gotta lose some of these. I'm not gonna be making 9 cheese toasties. We're gonna lose the bottom 4 of these. So that means Coco, you're gone. Follow Your Heart, sorry mate. Green V, not gonna toasty you. I feel bad, but gotta do it. And then we're also gonna get rid of the Violife Cheddar Block. A top 5. A top 5 who are winning in the taste test so far and the melt test so far. But can they pass the toasty test? Let's find out. Toasties are done. Super smoky in this room now. And in fact, one of these is just a little bit too brown. Now what I did was I used the Jamie Oliver little crown technique where you get a lovely cheesy crown on top of your toasty. And that was really good for putting the cheeses through their paces. The Vegan Mild from Cheese is looking really good over here. That is fantastic. It's interesting to see with both Applewood and Mexicana, both quite new cheeses to the market, that they're still quite oily, even a little while after cooking. The Cheese Vegan Mature, probably the least good of the bunch, I would say, right here. And then this Epic Mature over here, which has definitely had just a touch too long on the pan, has done a really nice job of firming up as well. Let's get Ian down and see what he thinks and give them their final scores. Ian,
So these are the five contenders.
Okay.
They are the five with the highest scores out of all the cheddars.
Nice.
And I guess what I need from you is mark out five on each one.
Well, I reckon I can do that. let's have a go. So this is the first one. That is legit. That is very good. I actually really like that one.
I genuinely think I'm gonna give that five.
Right, so this is the next one. Oh, it's got a good pull on it, good pull.
Mm.
Texture's certainly different, and flavour's certainly different.
Mm.
I prefer the first one because it's slightly more subtle.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna give that, a three.
Next one in the toasty taste test.
Mm.
It's so interesting that you don't know what these are.
Yeah, I genuinely have no idea.
Okay, go for it.
Ooh, okay. It is good, but it's not your traditional like cheddar per se. I think I still will say that the first one was my fave. I'm gonna give this one, I'm gonna give that a three again.
Next up, oh look at that.
Yeah, that was good.
Softer.
Chopped straight down.
Mm.
Yeah, I like that one as well.
Mm.
Quite a lot. But in my head, I'm gauging how good is this? How good would it be on beans on toast?
Yeah.
And I think the answer to that would be pretty good, so I'm gonna give that a four.
Four.
And last but not least, here we go.
Final toasty. Slightly browner than it should be.
Yeah, it smells good. Really nicely. Wow. Mm. The cheese pull on that is really good.
Yeah. This would give a good pull, wouldn't it?
Really, really good.
Mm.
Between these two, there's not much in it, so I'll give it a four as well.
Mm. Well, scores on the doors then. Let's reveal. So this one is 5 points.
Mm-hmm.
Added to its 10 before gives it 15.
That's a solid score, right?
That's full marks.
Is it actually max?
Full marks in every category.
Oh my god.
This one, which had a 3, and its previous one was a 9, so that's going to give it a 12.
So it's a very respectable score.
This one has a 3, added to an 8 is going to give it an 11. This one is a 4.
Mm-hmm. And what did it get before?
Added to a 7.
Oh yeah.
11. And finally, 4. Added to a 7, 11, oh my goodness, I don't even need to move the cheeses around.
No.
The scores are in order. Tie for third
place. So everyone got a medal.
Everyone got a, that's true.
Tied in third place.
Epic Mature by Violite, which was very epic and mature.
Yeah, is that a new one? I think
it's brand new, yeah.
Fair play.
And then Cheese is Mature.
Nice.
That was also in third place with 11 points. And the Mexicana Vegan.
11 is a really good score. These guys are doing good.
Yeah. Second place. Drum roll.
Drum roll for the cheese!
You already knew it. It is the Applewood Vegan Cheese, second place.
And don't get me wrong, that is a good cheese.
Yeah.
It great in mac and cheese, that.
Yeah, incredible. And finally, first place, the best cheese in the toasty test, in the taste test, and in the melty test, it got full marks.
Drum roll for the last time.
Vegan cheddar cheese.
Championship of the world.
First place, the cheese. Ooh. Vegan mild cheddar.
Okay, so she's smashed it then.
She's absolutely smashed it. It's like, it's subtle. It's cheesy, it melts well, but also it dried well. It's like, it's kind of like the perfect all-round cheddar cheese. So do subscribe if you haven't already. We're making more and more videos like this. We cook recipe videos every single day, and hit that little notification bell so that you can know when we post our next one.
All right, guys, been a pleasure.
Absolute pleasure.
Peace,
see ya.